just a few kilometres from here, the fires have been burning. Homes have been lost, lives have been lost. This has been a national tragedy to see these fires burning across many states, and indeed they are still burning. And our thoughts are with our emergency service personnel, our volunteer firefighters, and all those families and communities that have been devastated by these fires. Our focus, the Morrison government's focus, is on response and recovery, ensuring that those people who need help are getting help. That's why we've established the National Bushfire Recovery Agency under the leadership of Andrew Colvin, the Federal Police Commissioner. That is why we have committed an initial and additional $2 billion on top of disaster recovery payments and allowances. And that's why the Australian Defence Force have had an unprecedented call out of reservists across many states. Now 2,700 of them are at work in the bushfire relief effort. I'm also pleased that $42 million has already gone out to the states to make its way to local governments for their initiatives. Some $40 million has gone to 30,000 people in terms of disaster relief payments and support. And as we are standing here today, Chinooks and Hercules and Black Hawk helicopters are ferrying disaster relief and supplies to those who need it, as well as our emergency service personnel. Now, yesterday the Prime Minister made a very significant announcement with the Health Minister about $76 million for mental health support. Today we're making an announcement about $50 million as an initial contribution to protecting our wildlife and restoring the habitat. This has been an ecological disaster, a disaster that is still unfolding. Some 8 million hectares have been burnt, and we know that our native flora and fauna have been very badly damaged. So this money will importantly go to saving the lives of our wonderful native flora and fauna. And what we've seen today from Sue is a number of the koalas who have been badly burnt just kilometres from here are now undergoing important recovery and treatment. And the love and the affection that is being given by these volunteers and staff here at the Koala Hospital is something really to be seen. But I'll hand you over now to Sussan Ley. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Treasurer. It's terrific to be here with you, and you have been an Environment Minister, so delighted to have your support, not just for the announcement today, but for the ongoing funding that restoring our precious and unique environment will need. And Pat Conaghan, we got here. Pat has been a fearless advocate for these communities in the lead-up to Christmas, when you were at the front line of bushfires, and one of the reasons we're here is to demonstrate, Pat, that we're responding to your community's needs and that we understand that we need to be here for the longer term when it comes to the mapping, the discovering of the unburnt areas within the burnt fire grounds, and bringing the restoration and recovery. We've started that work up here in northern New South Wales already. Leslie Williams, you as the state member have been a champion of this region and this zoo. Sue Ashton has taken us for a tour of the koalas, and unsurprisingly they all have names and they all have unique identities, and they are all individually extraordinary and they all matter, as does every single wildlife that's been affected by these fires. So thank you, Sue, for the work that you're doing. Today, as the Treasurer said, this is our initial response for the environment when it comes to the bushfire tragedy. And I've just stepped away from my own communities in rural New South Wales, 70 k's from my hometown. There are fires burning in the Upper Murray. And we're talking, I was talking yesterday about the built environment and the rural environment and our farmers. Today I'm talking about the environment. We as a government will respond across all three fronts as we go forward and manage what is, as Josh has said, an unfolding ecological tragedy. So 50 million today, and if I can broadly break it up, 25 for our wildlife carers and hospitals, our zoos that are standing ready to do what they do best, breed insurance populations and get out there in the field and help, and our natural resource management bodies, because one of the biggest threats that wildlife faces post-bushfire is feral animals. So we need to get those areas fenced off, we need to identify habitat, and we need to provide food, shelter and water for the animals. Now, the other $25 million that is part of today's announcement, I stress it's all our initial response, will be managed by Dr. Sally Box, our Threatened Species Commissioner. Because what we do need to do is coordinate our expert advice. And so Sally has convened and will chair, along with me, an expert panel that will inform us about what we should do. Because there is so much in the science, the environment, the ecology, the indigenous land management and farm space that we can learn from. So we're bringing those people together and they're actually going to give us that advice. So this is about government listening, acting. You will see money coming out the door in days, right where it's needed. And the ongoing conversations that I'm having with those groups is helping us give the best possible response as a federal government. This is coordination, coordination with volunteers, coordination with state governments and state agencies, and together we will manage this because this is a huge opportunity for our country to recover our habitat and to recognise the extraordinary value of our wildlife and the iconic Australian bush in which it lives. So Sally, I'd love you to talk a little bit about that science response that I've mentioned.
Thank you very much, Minister. As the Minister said, she's asked me to convene an expert panel who will help guide the government's response to this bushfire crisis. This expert panel will have a few roles. We'll be looking at trying to assess the impacts of these fires on our threatened species and our wildlife and our plants and animals, mapping to try to understand where the fires have been and which species may have been in their path has already begun. We'll be looking at those maps and looking at what further information we need to assess those impacts. We'll be trying to prioritise the species, the places that we most need to focus our efforts, and then look at the type of actions that might need to be done. That might be about protecting habitat where you've got those vulnerable species remaining. It may be about controlling pests and weeds. It may be about securing threatened species populations and getting them into the zoos. And also there's the planning for that long-term habitat restoration effort. So I'm convening this panel. It'll include experts from CSIRO, from the universities, from the zoos and from our own Indigenous advisory committee. We'll have fire ecologists, conservation biologists, expertise in captive breeding. We'll have a range of expertise on that panel. That panel will meet very quickly. That panel will meet on Wednesday to start looking at where we most need to guide our efforts. But as the Minister and the Treasurer have said, collaboration is key here. We've had a huge outpouring of support from the private sector, from the non-government sector, and of course from our state and territory governments as well. So we'll all need to work together and coordinate to make sure that all of our collective resources are going where they need to go.